tenth one. Electrons are fired with velocity of 2.55 into 10 raised to 7 meter per second at right angle to the magnetic field of 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 2 Tesla. The specific charge of electrons, specific charge means E by M, is 1.7 into 10 raised to 11. What is radius of circular path of the electron? Electron enters in magnetic field, therefore EVB equal to MV square upon R. So E by M into B, E by M into B upon V equals to 1 by R. I did this way so that I get E by M. So 1.7 into 10 raised to 11. B is 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 2. And velocity is 2.55 into 10 raised to 7. This is equals to 1 by R. 1.15 into 7 is 105. Carry 10. 15 into 115 plus 1 plus 10, 25. So this will be equals to 1 upon R equals to 2.55 into 10 raised to 9 upon 2.55 into 10 raised to 7. Therefore, R will be 10 raised to 7 upon 9, 10 raised to minus 2 meter, 10 raised to minus 2 meter, or you can say 1 centimeter. Option C, 1 centimeter.
Done, sir.
Sum number 11. A proton and alpha particle having same momentum are fired through a magnetic field if R1, R plus 2 respectively are their radii, then what is relation between R1 upon R2? One is proton, other is alpha. When charge enters in magnetic field, same concept MV square by R is given. So QRB is MV and MV is called momentum. Now momentum is same they are telling. So Q of proton upon Q of alpha, R of proton, R of alpha, B is same cancel, momentum same cancel. Charge of alpha is double that of proton into Rp upon R alpha 1. So Rp upon R alpha will be 2. This is R1 upon R2 is 2. We want R1 R2 ratio 2. Yes. Thank you. Yes, completed.
Yes, sir.
Next one, 12.
Number 12.
Just read 12th one. Or 12th we did, no sorry, 12th we have to start. Mass of proton is 1840 times mass of electron. Mass of proton is 1840 times mass of electron. An electron and proton are fired perpendicular to the same magnetic field, same kinetic energy. Then radius of curvature of proton to electron will be how much ratio? So again, charge enters in magnetic field, same concept we are doing, mv square by r. Same kinetic energy, so I'm converting this vs twice kinetic energy upon m. Therefore qrb is m square twice kinetic energy upon m in root, 1m will get cancelled. So charge of proton upon electron, radius of proton upon electron, field same cancel, mass of proton upon mass of electron. Charge of proton is same as electron, cancel, radius of proton upon electron, 1840 times mass of electron upon mass of electron, this will get cancelled. Therefore, this is nothing but close to 43. Close to 43, that is option C. It can't be 60 because 60 ka square is 3600, so closest is 43. Complete.
None, sir.
A beam of electron passes through crossed electric and magnetic field. Crossed means perpendicular, electric and magnetic field. Beam of electron remains undeviated. What is velocity? So electric field is 7.2 into 10 raised to 6 Newton per coulomb and magnetic field is 2.4 Tesla. Since beam of electron remains undeviated, therefore electric force is balancing magnetic force. Electric force is EE, magnetic force is EBB. So velocity is E upon B. That is 7.2 into 10 raised to 6 upon 2.4. 3 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. Answer. 3 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. That is option B.
डन सर।
14 इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑफ चार्ज ई इज लिबरेटेड फ्रॉम द हॉट फिलामेंट एंड अट्रैक्टेड बाय एनोड पोटेंशियल वी वोल्ट देन व्हाट इज द स्पीड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन सो काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर विच इज ऑल्सो इक्वल्स टू ई इंटू वी ई मीन्स चार्ज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन वी इज पोटेंशियल So velocity v is 2 evm upon root of 2 evm. This is capital E given v upon m. 2 ev upon m option B.
Done, sir.
15. Photoelectric effect is the phenomenon in which photon comes out. No, photon comes out wrong. Electrons come out of metal with constant velocity, which depends upon the frequency and intensity. Nahin. Electron comes out from the metal with different velocity, not greater than certain value. So D option. 15th ka D. 15th. An electron is accelerated through potential of 200 volts. If E by M for electron is E by M for electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to 11 coulomb per kg. The velocity acquired by electron will be again same formula. Velocity is twice of E V upon M in root. So E by M is 1.6 into 10 raised to 11. V is 200 volt in root. So 1.6 into 2, 3.2. 3.2 into 200 is 640 into 10 raised to 11. That means 64 into 10 raised to 12. So this becomes 8 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. Option A. Till 19th I am doing, then I am starting with you. Next class, this chapter will get over and I will start with then semiconductor and then electromagnetic wave. So that should complete our full part one, part two. And then every week, part two ka test, one test of part two and one test will be of part one. Part one will be current chapter going on, part two, which we have already done.
None.
Okay. 17th theory. Photoelectric effect is phenomenon in which light energy is converted into electrical energy. Correct? B option. Light energy is converted into electrical energy. Planck's work was connected with quantum nature of radiation. Planck's work was with quantum nature, that is T. threshold wavelength depends upon what? Threshold wavelength will depend upon work function. Work function जितना कम ज्यादा threshold will be उतना कम ज्यादा. Okay, followed ना 17, 18.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Now I'm doing theory of electrons and photons further. Graph of intensity photo electric current versus frequency. So actually now we are studying characteristics of photoelectric effect, which after understanding this graphs will write as a statement. Photoelectric current versus frequency. If intensity of light is kept constant and potential of anode is kept constant, anode potential is kept constant at positive with respect to cathode, that means electron liberated can be attracted. Yeah, meaning if frequency is zero, that means actually light is not incident, we don't get photoelectric current. When we go on increasing frequency, a stage is reached when frequency becomes equal to threshold, then photoelectrons are emitted and current starts increasing. So this is graphical representation of photoelectric current and frequency, which states that photoelectrons are emitted only when frequency is greater than certain minimum frequency called as threshold. Just draw the diagram. This writing part I will give you as characteristics.
सर ये कर्व है कि स्ट्रेट लाइन है?
नहीं नहीं कर्व है,
मतलब स्क्वायर पे डिपेंड करेगा फ्रीक्वेंसी.
स्क्वायर मतलब समझा नहीं, क्या स्क्वायर?
सर ये कर्व है ना, तो
कर्व का मतलब नॉन लीनियर इक्वेशन है. फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट जब हम चालू करेंगे उसका इक्वेशन में आएगा कुछ तो माइनस, वो शायद आपको मालूम होगा क्योंकि आपने अटेंड किया होगा लेक्चर लास्ट ईयर. तो काइनेटिक एनर्जी आपको मिलेगा एच यू माइनस वर्क फंक्शन.
यस,
तो इसलिए बिकॉज ऑफ दैट टर्म इट इज नॉट परफेक्टली स्ट्रेट लाइन, थोड़ा सा कर्व. Can I clear this graph?
Yes, sir.
Now, photoelectric current versus intensity. Intensity means nothing but number of photons incident per unit time, comma per unit area, upon time upon area. So intensity. So when the number of photon goes on increasing, that means more packets or bundles are incident on surface of photosensitive material. If the energy is greater than threshold, then each photon will be absorbed by one electron, each photon will be absorbed by one electron, and they will be liberated. So jaise main number of photon badhaunga with same energy, the current will start increasing like this linearly. So photoelectric current is directly proportional to intensity, because photoelectric current depends upon electron and electron depends upon photon. So therefore it is a straight line. Every photon's energy is greater than work function. This we have to ensure. So, ek photon, ek electron. Do photon, do electron. Three photon, three electron. So, as you increase intensity, that means number of photon, number of photoelectrons starts increasing. So, current starts increasing linearly.
डन
ग्राफ ऑफ फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक करंट वर्सेस पोटेंशियल फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक करंट वर्सेस पोटेंशियल सी एवरी कैथोड हैज गॉट लिमिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टू बी एमिटेड पर सेकेंड उसके बाद वो नहीं एमिट कर सकता Suppose it has capacity of emitting 100 electron per second and you have made the voltage 10. Suppose 10 volt पे उसने सब electron को खींच लिया तो 11 पे भी उसके पास 100 electron है 12 पे भी उतने ही है 13 पे उतने ही है That time current becomes saturated. So suppose I start decreasing the potential till some point current will not change. That indicates at this potential it got saturated. तो आगे कितना भी बढ़ाया फर्क नहीं पड़ा सो सेम वे इफ आई डिक्रीज अप टू सर्टेन लेवल करंट विल रिमेन सैचुरेटेड देन इट स्टार्ट्स डिक्रीजिंग स्टिल इट इज नॉट जीरो व्हेन पोटेंशियल इज जीरो बिकॉज सम इलेक्ट्रॉन विल हैव एनर्जी सफिशिएंट इनफ टू रीच टू द कलेक्टर विदाउट वोल्टेज बीइंग पॉजिटिव लेकिन जब निगेटिव किया तो दे विल रिपेल द इलेक्ट्रॉन एट सर्टेन निगेटिव पोटेंशियल most energetic electron will be stopped that is called stopping potential now suppose I increase intensity then at same voltage current jyada rehta hai intensity jyada matlab photon jyada again it will become zero but you have increased the frequency so iska stopping potential zero thoda dur aake jayega because jitna energy jyada hello
yes sir
If I increase the intensity, then it is found that more photoelectrons are emitted, so more will be collected. But potential जब ही कम किया, तो धीरे-धीरे-धीरे कम-कम होके ये वही voltage पे zero होगा, क्योंकि आपने frequency नहीं बढ़ाया। अगर frequency बढ़ा था, तो stopping potential, देखो kinetic energy, अभी मैं थोड़ी देर के बाद करने वाला हूँ एक Einstein equation, ये depend करेगा frequency पे। तो ये तो वर्क फंक्शन होता है जो हर एक मटेरियल के लिए कांस्टेंट होता है तो अगर मैं फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ाऊंगा तो एनर्जी बढ़ेगा तो स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल बढ़ेगा तो अगर मैंने इंटेंसिटी बढ़ाया लेकिन फ्रीक्वेंसी नहीं बढ़ाया तो स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल सेम रहने वाला है लेकिन अगर मैंने एनर्जी बढ़ा दिया तो स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल मतलब व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इंटेंसिटी आई एम कीपिंग कॉन्स्टेंट एनर्जी आई एम इंक्रीजिंग देन सी हाउ द ग्राफ frequency is increased then photoelectric current with potential at one frequency it will give me this characteristics ye apna aa gaya stopping potential this is suppose first frequency When second frequency is greater than first, तो इसका stopping potential आगे आएगा। मतलब जितना ज्यादा stopping potential, that indicates, देखना है ना, frequency बढ़ाया मैंने, intensity नहीं बढ़ाया। So intensity will remain same. बट स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल दूसरे वाले का इधर आया आर यू गेटिंग दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इंटेंसिटी इज केप्ट कॉन्स्टेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी इज इंक्रीज्ड तो एनर्जी ज्यादा मिला इलेक्ट्रॉन को पैकेट सेम है तो उसको रुकाने के लिए टाइम ज्यादा लगता ज्यादा वोल्टेज लगेगा ना हेलो
यस सर गॉट
Just draw these two diagram because graphical MCQs they can ask of this type.
Done, sir.
Okay. Now, is it instantaneous phenomenon or it takes some time? That means when light is incident, is it that after 10 minutes, 20 minutes, it will liberate the electron or it will be instantaneous phenomenon?
Sir, it will depend on a threshold frequency.
If threshold frequency is a jada is the incident energy of photon, then
instantly,
then it will be instantaneous phenomenon. That means moment the photoelectrons are incident, it will not wait for time for the photoelectrons to be liberated. So it is instantaneous phenomenon. Next right heading, characteristics of photoelectric effect. Characteristics of photoelectric effect. First point, photoelectrons are emitted only when frequency is photoelectrons are emitted only when frequency is greater than certain minimum frequency called as threshold frequency. The photoelectric current is directly proportional to the intensity of light. Kinetic energy of photoelectrons depends upon frequency, but not on intensity. Fourth point, it is instantaneous phenomena.
Yes, sir.
Einstein's photoelectric equation. All numericals are based on this. Einstein's photoelectric equation. Einstein assumed Planck's quantum theory to explain phenomenon of photoelectric equation. According to Planck's quantum theory, energy of each photon or quanta is E equals to h nu when it is incident on photosensitive material, then entire energy is absorbed in single dose. That means it is not gradual, but it is absorbed in single dose. It is utilized for two purposes. First one, to overcome work function W0. Second, to liberate electrons with maximum kinetic energy, Ke max. Just copy till this, then I'm framing the formula. H nu is nothing but work function plus Ke max.
डन सर।
सो नाउ एनर्जी एच न्यू इज वर्क फंक्शन प्लस के मैक्स। सो के मैक्स will become h nu minus work function. So actually this is Einstein's photo electric equation. Now k max we can write half p maximum square h nu minus work function. E into stopping potential is also k max is h nu minus work function. So we have three formulas for Einstein equation in terms of k max, half the maximum square, E into stopping potential. Right for that.
Done.
Graph of K max versus frequency. Since K E max is h nu minus work function, this we are taking along y axis, frequency along x. Our formula will become like y equals to mx plus c. So can I say this represents straight line? So graph will be straight line but not passing through origin. So K max graph versus frequency will be straight line intersecting y axis at work function, because C is minus, therefore it is cutting at negative y quadrant. So here slope will be h and y intercept will be equals to work function. H means Planck's constant. Draw first graph and write this slope is equal to h, y intercept equal to work function.
Done, sir.
Graph of stopping potential वर्सेस फ्रीक्वेंसी स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल वर्सेस फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो के मैक्स इक्वल्स टू एच न्यू माइनस वर्क फंक्शन. That means E into stopping potential is H nu minus work function. So stopping potential will be H naught upon E minus work function upon E. So this Y intercept is work function upon E and slope is H naught upon E. Y intercept is work function upon E. That is work function in electron volt. When you divide by E, it becomes electron volt. Draw this graph of stopping potential versus potential. Yes, completed.
Yes.
Can I clear this pole now? एक वैल्यू याद रखना आप लोग. एच सी अपॉन ई इज 12.43 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 7. सो वेन एवर दिस कम्स आई विल डिरेक्टली पुट 12.43 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 7. What is photoelectric cell? Photoelectric cell. Any cell will give you output electrical energy. So a device which converts light energy into light energy into electrical energy is called as photoelectric cell. Right. Applications. It's used in burglar's alarm is used to find correct time for which a body must be exposed for photograph. Must be exposed for photograph.
None.
So that's all for today. We'll meet now tomorrow as per our usual.